about the NYSC. Social media went crazy because Davido Obio, the president of the 30 Billion Gang, who is now 30,19,800 Gang, he's joined the NYSC core members. He's decided to serve his country, quote unquote, serve his country. We'll take a look at the video. When we watch the video, Leila and I will come back to talk some more about his NYSC, the effect it's had on Nigerians. And really, is it really that much of a big deal? We'll take a look at the video.
Just register for NYC. Come in.
You don't need your copa.
We. Copa. We. I don't want to put my account. So they're like, we don't.
Now that is a classic case of Nadem de Rushers.
NYC, we know they rush them.
I'm telling you.
Celebrities like us.
Nadem de Rushers. I'm telling you. I am telling you. But
that's
honestly,
a very interesting one.
I'm telling you. That is actually very interesting. I'm sure we have a lot to say on this in particular, but I'm going to ask you to begin while I gather my thoughts.
Let me start from the good side, you know, the positives.
Yeah.
Positive being that the NYC was established after the Nigerian Civil War, sometime around 1973, to foster unity, national unity. Of course, what Davido did looks like it was fostering national unity, unity among the youth.
Yeah.
The young people, we are coming together for a common cause to celebrate OBU. No, I'm just messing. Now, being very serious, I'd like to look at it from a conversation of what really is the point of NYSC. We know, as a matter of fact, that Davido is not going to be able to serve. He's a celebrity. He's a public figure. Are they going to post him to a local government? It'll be interesting to see Davido teaching in a grammar school, in a secondary school. You know, it'll be interesting to see Davido really serving. I'm wondering if he's going to be the one serving or if NYSC is going to be the one serving him.
But then
again, it leads me to the conversation we've had all this while. Should NYSC be scrapped or should it be restructured? There's several conversations surrounding this. We know that he's doing this to tie up loose ends. He put it up on his caption. He said, tying up all loose ends. In Nigeria, it is now like a ground rule that if you're going to run for politics, you have to have evidence of having gone through the National Youth Service Corps. You know, this, of course, is him going through the process to fulfill all righteousness. Kemi Adeosun has been in the news. We've been asking since for her to speak about her NYSC certificate. And I'm sure you have something to say about that as well.
Absolutely,
but for me, I'm like, what is really the point of the NYSC? I don't see any point for the NYSC.
Okay, I'll kick off with your first point about the unity that NYSC is supposed to promote. I think it's great that you can have public figures going and serving in a particular place and actually bringing unity to a particular environment. I'm sure if half of the people there, or at least 99% of the people that were serving, knew that Davido was going to be serving in camp, like, they would have literally been so ready for NYSC. They must have been hit by surprise when they saw him post it on Instagram and they're like, wait, so are we going to be in the same camp as Davido? You know, the fact that he was up there performing, I think that was great. And I think it was something good for him to give back to his society. Now, you're in a position as a public figure. And yes, what time do you have to serve? It is of no, it's, we don't even need to discuss that. Davido is not going to serve. And then that raises a lot of questions. Do some people get leeway over certain things and some people don't? Because under the NYSC constitution, as we see see it, the only person granted leeway, apart from the leeway from camp if you have any medical condition, are those who, quite frankly, graduated after the age of 30. Davido is still in his mid-20s. We know that he is not going to be working at any local government school. He is going to continue touring the world and pushing out his music. And quite frankly, I believe that that is a greater and a better service as someone who has talent in the entertainment industry that you can give back to your country, Nigeria. But what exactly is Nigeria giving to you? How much is Nigeria supporting the entertainment industry? How are our IP laws actually protecting our artists like Davido that do everything that they can to put Nigeria on the map, to put Africa on the map? And this is where my issue comes in. And yes, now with regards to Kemi Adeosun, enough is enough, Nigeria. I have been calling her out day by day. President Muhammadu Buhari has gone silent. News came out stating that she did not do her NYSC. Her exemption was never approved. She is sitting there as a Minister of Finance, and the entire administration has gone quiet as to what the update is. Quite frankly, this is a democracy, and we ask for transparency at all times. And we, as the people, definitely want to know exactly what is going on. So definitely, on behalf of the Nigerian people, we are calling, like Enough is Enough Nigeria, on the Nigerian government to give us an update with regards to Kemi Adeosun, the Minister of Finance. Because if you can sit in public office having not done your NYSC, meanwhile, there's some people that cannot even secure private jobs in MSMEs because they don't have NYSC, then I have
question,
an issue. Go for
why
it.
Why are we doing NYSC? What really is the purpose of an NYSC? I felt when I was serving that NYSC was just punishment for having gone to school to study for 5 years and to go to law school for 1 year. I felt it was undue punishment, undue hardship, and if there was a way that I would not allow my kids go through that, I definitely would not. Yeah. I don't understand the culture of coming in and you're carrying your box and you're doing frog jumps for like, you're doing like 20 frog jumps as you're welcoming to NYSC, and then they take you into a room where you have bugs everywhere, you barely have a mattress to sleep, you're bathing with water that is colored, and people are falling sick. My friend was giving me her experience. She came back from the UK to come and do her NYC, Kenny, and she was sick for 6 months. She didn't want to attend. Her parents kept thinking, oh, you're being such a sports girl, Kenny. Go do your NYC. And she went to Kano. She came back and she was sick for 6 months. 6 months, Layla. So if we are going to continue this system, then something has to change.
Yeah.
You can't bring people who have been through a university that has punished them enough. They say you don't have to go to hellfire. Having gone through the system that Nigeria provides, is hellfire enough? You go through the Nigerian universities where you use candles to read, where you're like 8 in a room crammed up together like your stockfish. And then you go through all these harrowing situations and then come out and you go to NYC. You suffer again. You're earning $19,800 a month. You're supposed to live your life, do transport, do everything with the $19,800. And then you're posted to offices where they turn you into an errand boy or an errand girl. What exactly is the point of NYC? Yeah. If I had my way, we will not have NYC, or we will totally restructure it.
To be very honest with you, I completely understand your pain and I completely resonate with what you're saying. The notion of NYSC has been completely, completely dilapidated over the years. As in, what NYSC stood for back in the 1970s is not what NYSC stands for today. You hear certain accounts of people who are in camp and certain things that are happening to them and you're like, is this really going on in a democratic country? Is this what people are being led to do? Now, I am for the restructuring of NYSC. However, Nigeria in itself as a state needs to get to a certain level of economic prosperity, of social sustainable development, and of political stability in order for us to actually have a state that can secure their citizens under NYSC and ensure that NYSC is actually beneficial and not a waste of 1 year. Because 1 year of someone's life, I'm sorry to say, it is not a joke. So if you are going to ask your citizens to come and serve you for 1 year, let us also ask you to serve us, because that is also your role and that is also what you're supposed to be doing. And quite frankly, I agree with you on that. And I am for, at this point, with the way NYSC has become, I do stand for the scrapping of NYSC. I do believe that NYSC is something that has completely lost its meaning. Nigeria needs to develop its institutions. And maybe down the line, when we are more sustainably developed, we can bring back a similar concept.
Very
for now,
true.
Overhaul it.
We totally need to either scrap or restructure. Now, that is not to say that it hasn't had its positive side. There are people who will tell you tales of love that blossomed from the NYC Mami Market camp and then led to marriage. Some will tell you of their jobs that they got all because they were serving. Yes, They are good tales, but then they're not enough compared to the negatives that have trailed NYC. I mean, lots of people have suffered from it. I hated being in camp. I just told myself, you know what? Just prepare your heart that you're going there to go and enjoy yourself regardless. And then I joined the orientation broadcasting service and I was like their reporter there. But at the end of the day, there's so many things that need to be changed. But maybe you can share with us your NYC experience. You probably can't understand anything I'm saying. You probably think, oh, what's she saying? I had it so beautiful. NYC was the best thing that ever happened to me. Then let me know.
To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.